我也没有想到自己能得金奖，因为有一首曲子练习的时间不是很长，觉得自己表现的时候还是会有瑕疵。Hi Music 有很多弹得很好的小朋友，我得了奖觉得自己很幸运，不过知道自己得了奖还是特别开心。
所以就是其实我自己也没有想到就是说能拿什么奖啊，因为就是这种东西的话，裁判他判这种东西是很主观的，就是音乐的话他们每个人都有自己的想法，所以就是对于选手来说的话，就是尽量展示自己所懂的这些东西，然后展示出来让裁判他们判。然后其实这回拿奖的话其实也是比较 surprising 的。对，
well, needlessly to say, I'm pretty happy about being able to get gold prize in both the categories I competed in. I feel like the prizes really acknowledge the work I put into my practicing. And right after I finished competing, I wasn't quite sure if I would get prizes or not, because judging music is very perspective based, since it's art after all. Like, one judge could think like my interpretation is like great, while another judge may think that I should approach the piece in a different way. But in the end, it worked out well for me, and I was able to get gold in both the categories.
我弹了克莱门蒂的 Sonata No. 36和 Mike Springer 的 Tango Collateral。Sonata 因为跑动太多，所以我练了好久，范老师也在一遍遍帮我抠细节。 Tango Collateral 因为特别好听，我很喜欢，所以练的时间就比较短。比赛期间每天都需要练好久，所以都没有玩耍的时间。
This time I competed in two categories. In the normal semi competition category, I played Jadot by Ravel and the first movementof the Italian Concerto by J.S. Bach. In the separate concerto category of the semi competition, I played the first movement of Concerto in A minor by Grieg. And leading up to the competition, it's very important to practice all the pieces daily, because only that will build you enough confidence to play well when you are performing in front of all the judges. And another thing to note is to pay attention to all the tiny details in all of your pieces when you're practicing, because when judging hundreds of people, the judges will have to pick on all the tiniest details, which will separate the competitors who get a gold prize from those who won't.
这次比赛我弹的是巴赫和这个 Ravel 的曲子啊，这两个曲子其实都是我恩师幻一鸣老师他就是特别擅长的两种风格的啊，所以这两首曲子的话我是从年初一直准备到现在差不多半年的时间，其实也是花了很多心思在上面，因为我老师也是比较在意就是音色和音乐的这种表达，所以就是我们在练习的时候也会更加注意这一点。